performing. Another unique quality is that you guys at home and you guys here get to ask the guys some questions. Who wants to get down to business? I do as well. So you know what? Let's not waste any more time. Let's give it up. These guys have sold over 4 million worldwide. Let's give it up for Cincinnati's favorite sons, 98 Degrees.
What's up, Toronto?
tonight.
Yeah, yeah.
Once again, we are 98 Degrees.
That's right.
We want to thank each and every one of you for coming out here tonight to support us. We want to thank everyone watching on Much Music tonight. We see you out there. We love you. Thanks for tuning in. Right now, we want to do a song. It's very special to us as a group. This is the song we like to dedicate to our fans all around the world as we tour around the world. And tonight here in Toronto, we want to dedicate this song to each and every one of you and all of you watching on TV. We wouldn't be possible without each and every one of you out there. And this is our way of telling you just that, because this song is all because of you.
I'm
cure against my fear and my pain. Because I'm losing my mind when you're not around. And it's all because of you.
Thank you.
That's right.
Thank you very much.
It is all because of you that song was a big hit for 98 Degrees, and we want to take this time to thank you all very, very much. All the fans here in Toronto and all around the world, it means so much to us. And right now, we want to do a song that's very, very special to us. Now, this is a song that has actually been featured in a lot of people's weddings we've been hearing lately, so we're very flattered by anybody who would have this song in their wedding. And right now, we want to dedicate this song to all the beautiful ladies here tonight. Because we want you to know that we really do cherish each and every one of you. So this song right here is called I Do. Y'all ready?
Is that I Do?
I don't know. That's not I
that
Do.
Sound
that
like
sounds
I Do.
Like another song that was kind of
we better save that till later in the show. Now, what we're going to do right now is take you back to I Do. Anybody hear that on the radio up here in Canada? I Do? Yeah?
Anybody seen the video?
Don't worry. None of us got the girl. If any of you seen the video, you can see none of us got the girl. Screech got the girl. What's up with that, huh?
Put a round of applause for Screech.
This song goes out to anyone and everyone who's in love watching on Much Music tonight. All I hear, all I'll be, everything in this world, all that I'll ever need is in your eyes, shining in me. Your hand brushes mine, and the thousand sensations seduce me, 'cause I do cherish you for the rest of my life. You don't have to think twice. I will love you still from the depths of my soul.
From the rest of my soul, it's beyond my control.
to breathe.
We do cherish you, Canada. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks a lot.
Truly amazing right there. 98 degrees, everybody. You can keep it up. You can keep the trip. Fantastic stuff right there. We want to welcome the boys in 98 degrees back. It's good to have you guys back
here. Thanks, man. It's good to be back.
If they've been living under a rock for the past 4 years, I want to put names to the faces over here, okay? Starting at this end, Justin.
Justin, yes.
Right on. Nick over here.
Nick, how you doing?
We got Jeff.
What's up, guys?
And way down there at the end, we got Drew. 98 degrees, everybody. Excellent stuff.
Thank you, guys.
I was looking for a Kleenex up there, because that song, every time I hear that song, it was a little tear.
Oh, it's a tearjerker.
You're still crying because we whipped you so hard in the boxing ring.
That's what it was. I didn't want to go there. I've been training.
I know you have.
Who's got some boxing gloves on them? No, maybe not. Okay, we won't go there then. So check that out. It's a very, very special night. I was telling them earlier, you guys are not only performing tonight, but you guys here and you guys at home get to interact with the band. You get to ask them some questions. You know what I'm saying? You at home in your houses, you're not just going to be lying there on your couches. Think of some good questions. And if you have some good questions, because this is all about you guys, with the help of 98 Degrees. Here's how you can reach the guys if you want to do that. Here are the numbers.
You can get intimate and interactive with 98 Degrees. The toll-free number to call is 1-800-265-MUCH. That's 1-800-265-6824. By fax, the number is area code 416-591-MUCH. That's area code 416-591-6824. You can email 98@muchmusic.com.
Right on. So those were the numbers right there. Those were the numbers if you guys want to get in touch with the band. And you know what? If the lines are busy, keep trying, because you guys are going to be here for the next 90 minutes,
we'll be here for a while.
Right?
We'll be answering phones for a while.
They usually get busy. Now, I've been thinking about this for a while. These people here, they look nice and warm. You're heating them up.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's hot.
It's a little warm.
So these people, they have it made. The people at home, they have it made, too. They got their popcorn. They're on their Lazy Boys. They have it made. There's a group of people that I'm really, really concerned about. Yeah, and those would be the people. Those would be the people right outside. You guys know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, we saw
these guys.
People.
These people have been here for...
Over there?
Well, yeah. You can come over if you want.
You can probably see
them. Come on, guys. These people have been here all day. And you know what? We're going to come say hello to them right now. Because you know what? It gets cold in December up in Canada.
Oh, my goodness. How's everybody doing out
these
there?
These people deserve something, too. You guys got the first glimpse of 98 Degrees. You know what? We will bring them back out. We will. It looks like they're coming out now. Isn't that nice? Isn't that special? Check this out. More with 98 Degrees as an intimate and interactive with the guys continues after the break. You just came over here to cool off, didn't you? Welcome back to an intimate and interactive featuring none other than 98 Degrees right here. Fantastic time. That first set was so good. You guys, some of you had to go outside and cool off right there, right?
It's a little warm in here.
They're heating things up in here, you guys. That was a nice cool down period, though.
It was very nice.
Now back to some serious business here. 98 Degrees and Rising is the CD. I'm holding up my hands right here. The title sort of says it all for you guys. 98 Degrees and Rising. You're on this sort of like ascension curve. You've had massive success. Are you guys still real? Like, when was the last time you guys took the garbage out?
Last week.
Yeah, last time.
Last week you did. Don't you have people for that?
No, we're the same guys that we've always been. I think it's, you know, we could attribute that to our parents, and they raised us to be very humble guys, and you know, I think we are, and we hope to remain that way forever, and we have each other to keep in line. So I mean, we don't see us acting egotistical or getting too big for our britches anytime soon, you know.
The question about, like, would you be able to walk into, like, a department store and just buy underwear for yourselves, or do you have stand-ins to do that for you?
You know what? We decided we want to try and remain as close to our normal lives as we can, you know? So we do still go buy our own underwear, we buy our own socks, we do our own stuff. You have to make certain adjustments to your life, I think, when you have success in this business. And you know, that's kind of, we've hesitantly made those changes. But at the same time, we do like to get out there in public and not live like hermits, you know what I mean?
It's all right. The guys have had a lot of success, haven't they? Everybody here. Yes? Sure they have. You guys can make some noise for that. It's kind of a... Okay, that's enough. Sorry. It's kind of a cool show because the people here, the people at home, get to ask you guys questions. And I think someone right behind my back here is anxiously awaiting to ask you guys a question. So if you want to say your name and say hi to the guys, then give us your question.
Hi, my name's Stacey Strike, and I'm from Carlton Place, which is a small town near Ottawa. And I'm a really big fan of you guys because I think your music's really inspiring and helpful. And I was wondering, what inspires you guys the most when you're on stage?
I think just the audience. The feedback we get from the audience, the energy we get from them. Yeah. Just like now. Having you guys here makes our job a lot easier. We can just go out there, interact with you guys, perform, feed off your guys' energy. And luckily we've recorded some songs that are very close to us that we really enjoy performing. So I think the combination of those two make our job extremely, extremely easy.
Yeah, that's good.
An answer?
Yeah.
Isn't he so cute?
Yes.
He's really a little teddy bear, right?
Pretty cute yourself there, right?
I think
not bad, man.
So check this out. Directly it's directly outside these... Did you have something else to say? I'm sorry. Okay.
And I also noticed in your video for this gift and on all the other shows you've been on lately, you didn't have any Christmas hats, so I brought you all guys some.
Thank you.
Very nice. Very nice. You can pass those out if you like. Yeah. And those might come in handy later on.
That's right.
Yeah. It'll be a surprise.
Absolutely.
They don't know what we're talking about.
Yeah, okay. We should save these for the special surprise.
Thank you very nice. That's very nice of you.
Thank you. That's really sweet.
So where's mine? Oh, that's right, you did. My boss took that. He has it up in his office right now. So directly outside these windows here at the corner of the street lies the world-famous Speaker's Corner booth. It's the innovator, right? It's a simple concept of this thing. You pop in a loony, and people get to speak their mind. We've, at Much Music, have created a wandering version of this where people from all across Canada get to ask, you know, questions and speak their mind directly to you guys tonight. So this first one is out in, I believe, Montreal somewhere, and I think Nadia has a question for you guys. So if you guys want to look up at this monitor here, I think we're going to go to Montreal, and Nadia, you go ahead.
Hi, my name is Nadia from Montreal, and my question is, if each of you could pick one of your songs that best describes you, which song would it be and why?
Wow. That's a really
best
good question.
Best describes us.
Wow.
I'm going to have to go with Invisible Man because over the long haul, my experience has been just that.
Because of the white hair?
No.
Okay.
Yeah. Good try.
That's a tough one.
You guys?
I'd probably have to say... Come and Get It off our first album.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah, Come and Get It, baby.
I like to think a lot of our songs are very good love songs, and you know, describe love as we feel it and I feel it. And I think that one of my favorites is Still, you know, because it describes kind of like everlasting love and love as good as it gets. And so I love having love like that. So Still is my favorite song, I think.
Right on, Jeff.
I'd have to say Heaven's Missing an Angel is my favorite off the first album. And it doesn't reflect me in any way. It's just a very special song to me because I was very close with my grandmother. The night we recorded the album, she passed away. And the song just has a very special meaning for me. And it's probably the song I'll cherish most out of any album we'll ever do and the albums we've already done.
Good words. When I was coming to work earlier on, there's somebody out there that had a sign saying, Heaven's Missing Four Angels. I thought that was really nice. I don't know if she's out there somewhere. I heard a scream. Say hello to you afterwards. We have a call right now on the phone line with us. Is Vicky. Vicky from Grimsey. How are you doing tonight, Vicky?
I'm doing good.
Yeah, say hi to the guys.
Hi, guys.
Hey, what's up, Vicky?
Hey, I love you guys so much, and you're a big inspiration to me.
Thank you.
And I love listening to your music because the past year I've had like a really hard time losing friends, and I just listen to your music and I feel better.
Well, good.
That's what it's for. I mean, that's the reason we do music, and one of the reasons we pick the songs we do is because the content is something that everyone can relate to. We like to pick songs that people can listen to and relate to them in their own lives, and we're glad that you've overcome some things with the songs.
Satisfying moments, I think, in our career are when we get letters and responses from our fans that, you know, they basically talk about how one of our songs helped them through a difficult time in their life. They were sick or their loved one was sick or, you know, whatever the case may be. That really makes us feel good inside to know that our music is touching people and helping them get through some difficult times. That's great.
Good words, guys. There you go. Vicky, you like that answer?
Yep.
Excellent. Yeah. Thanks for calling in, okay? Enjoy the rest of the show. Say goodbye to the guys.
Oh, okay, but I have one more question to ask.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Well, how do you guys feel about being a big influence on today's youth?
Honestly, I think we all understand that's a very big responsibility, and we have a lot of people looking at us kind of as role models, but honestly, we don't do anything differently now than we would ordinarily. I think we've all have high morals, and we're very spiritual guys, so we follow our hearts and we do what we feel is right pretty much all the time. So I guess if anybody has to be a role model, I think we all feel comfortable stepping into that position, and I think it's just part of the job. I think we're very honored to be considered role models.
Oh, okay. And can you sing happy birthday to my sister? It's her 18th birthday tomorrow.
Sure, we'll say happy birthday. Hey, what's up, sweetheart? Happy birthday.
Happy 18th birthday.
Happy 18th birthday.
That's so nice.
What a great age.
How nice are the 98 of you guys, Vicky? Come on.
Thanks again, Vicky.
Online with us right now. There's an email question, and if you want to look up here, you can do that. It's right up there somewhere. It says, hi, Drew, Justin, Jeff, and Nick. Also much. You guys are together on the road all the time. Like a family, what bad habits do you have that annoy each other? Your loving fan, Rhonda Mason. There you go. Bad habits, guys.
Uh-oh. I think every habit that these three have annoys me.
Drew is a bad habit that annoys me.
Giant annoyance in general. I think, like you said, we are a family, and we do get on each other's nerves like a family does.
Hey, grammar, you know? I do.
Stay in school, everybody.
You're a role model, right?
Yeah, I'm a role model. Stay in school. No, we give each other space when we need it, and we have a lot of respect for each other as adults and as individuals, so I think that's the key part, is when you are annoying somebody or somebody's annoying you, you just get out of the situation for a little while, you just back off, cool down, and then you come back to the family, and you continue the working relationship.
Very good. Good words there, Drew. Very good. You guys feel the same way?
He didn't say what bad habits he had. I'll step up to the plate.
There we go.
I'm gonna say that these guys will think that my worst habit is probably talking too much and just about nothing, and they get sick of hearing my mouth run. And I know it, but I keep doing it anyway because I like to do it and annoy them.
Prime example, right?
Exactly.
Point taken. Are we really doing bad habits?
Do you want to end off?
I like the way Drew just avoided the question. Yeah. I thought that was great. You had to bring it back to the band.
I probably snore too much and too loud. When everybody's watching the movie, I snore really loud.
That's a good...
It's one of many things.
You are annoying when you do that.
Check this out, guys. We were speaking about the original Speaker's Corner earlier on.
Yeah.
That's located right outside the window here. And I believe there's someone in there right now who has a question for you guys. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to walk over to the window here and see if... Oh, I knew that was going to happen. But isn't that nice and refreshing?
That's nice and refreshing, though.
You guys keeping warm out here? Okay. Someone is inside that speaker's corner right down there. So whenever you're ready, ask a question, whoever you are. So with the guys in 90 degrees, you guys can watch right up there, okay?
Hi, my name is Jenny, and I was just wondering, with all the touring and interviewing you do, if you guys have time to balance a professional and personal life with your family or a girlfriend?
That's a good question.
It is a tough aspect of what we do to balance your professional and personal life. And when you're in this business, I think we kind of live 90 degrees 24 hours a day. And obviously, we travel a lot and don't get to spend that much time with our loved ones. But we have a lot of expensive phone bills, and we try and call home and call our friends whenever we can. And basically, everyone that's close to us understands what we're going through, and they're there for us. And you know, you just make the best you can of it.
Very good. Excellent stuff. Who thinks Justin's sexy? I heard it over here. Someone said he's not invisible. There's no way he's invisible. So check this out. We got the guys out here earlier. Maybe we can get them out here to sing a few songs for you. That might be coming up. But you know what? We got to take a commercial break. More with 98 Degrees after the break. Interactive gathering with 98 degrees right here. You guys enjoying yourselves? Yes.
It is a little warm.
The sweaters on, maybe.
Yeah. It's
I think no matter what we would wear, this is gonna sound corny, right. But the heat from these people, we would be hot up here. They're so excited and fired up out there.
You're
totally right. You guys having a good time here? How about the people back there? Outside. You guys having a good time? Could you hear that? They were a little louder out there.
Yeah, really
you want to try that one more time?
It was pretty loud.
In here?
Outside.
Okay.
Nice.
Out there?
Yeah,
they're making a lot of noise out there.
They're so loud, they're coming through the glass.
They're a little bit louder.
These guys are here.
And they said that I was sexy, so I think we have to go.
All right, let's go say hello to them out there.
Let's see what's up there.
You guys were loud, though. You were very loud. Keep that up. But I think they do have it right. You guys get your jackets on?
Here they are. Yeah, I can hear the loudness now. Everybody, 98 degrees.
Yay. How we doing out here?
Which one of you said I was sexy?
98 degrees, everybody.
You guys aren't getting cold, are you?
Okay, this is what's gonna happen. When I do something like this, we need some quiet because we're gonna have some questions. We have a question right down here. So keep it down, everybody. We're gonna get a question right here. You guys ready for a question?
Yeah, let's take a question. Absolutely.
Okay. Hi, I want to say a special hello to Nick and Jeff from Shauna, my friend. My question is, what is the craziest thing a fan has ever done for you guys?
Wow.
We've had some fans do some very, very crazy things.
We've had fans fly basically halfway around the world to see. We just came back from Asia, and we had fans from California that flew all the way over to Taiwan. And
we had a couple of fans, a couple of ladies in their 30s. They followed us for like something like 27 cities straight, which is, I think, is the record for any fan.
That's our version of the Deadheads, yes.
Yeah, grateful 98 degrees.
Kind of crazy.
And so. We also have girls get tattooed.
I believe there's another question over here somewhere. What's your name?
My name's Kamisa.
You have a question for the guys?
Yeah, first, I just want to say hi to you guys. And my sister says hi in April. Say hi.
How you doing?
Okay, if you guys could pick any artist, past or present, who would you pick and why?
Then we wanted to meet?
To if meet. You could pick any artist, past or present, who would you pick?
To meet, you mean?
No, to work with.
Oh, to work with.
Yeah.
I would say Marvin Gaye. I'm a huge Marvin Gaye fan. I'd love to have the opportunity to meet him.
I might have to say Prince, or the artist, formerly artist Prince. Because he's a sexy...
I think I would pick Boys to Men.
Boys to Men.
The huge influence on us, Boys to Men, yes.
I think I would pick Sade. She's one of my favorite singers of all time, so I have to pick her.
How about you, Justin?
Marvin Gaye.
Right on. You guys are missing something up here. You need a leg. You're missing a leg.
From the musical world.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. What happened to that? Okay, you know what? Enough talk. They wanna perform right here, right now, you guys?
Yeah. Sure.
You guys ready to do it? Want to hear that, everybody? Whenever you guys are ready.
All right, everybody. This next song we're going to do for you guys tonight. It's a song that we co-wrote with two guys actually from here in Canada. And this song right here is about never-ending love. This song is called Still.
Everybody sing along with us now.
Cause deep in my soul I know, girl, that you are the only light I see. Your love means everything to me. I know that we will never part, cause you'll always be near, here in my heart.
Change seasons real. Taste of the way we got our start. We used to sing a lot of acapella, and right now we want to do a song that was written by a good friend of ours. And this is actually a song that we did on our demo, helped us get signed. And I think Nick has a question for everybody.
Before we get started, I just have one question for everybody here tonight, and it goes a little something like this. I want to make sure you can hear me.
Is it enough to say? Cherish you, and I know I always will. Is it enough to say I'm grateful for this miracle we share? Is it enough to know that I could never show you just how much I care?
Yeah. And right now, I don't know if anybody here came out to the video shoot that we did here just a couple months ago. Anybody? Anybody? Yeah, a couple people? Well, we did film it right here in Toronto, and we want to sing a little something for you.
For all those of you who are at the video shoot, you might recognize this little piece right here. Go something like this. 1, 2.
Cause I've been waiting to give this gift to man. I'm down on my knees. There's no better time. It's something to last for as long as you live. Tonight I'm gonna give you all my heart can give.
Yeah. Anybody recognize that song?
Yeah, I saw some people singing that. Yeah.
That song was actually written by a guy who wrote this other song for us. Called Because of You, and he co-wrote another song for us. So this song was the original song that we sang that Canada embraced so much, and it put us on the map.
Yeah.
It was the first song we ever came out with, and it was about a guy that was in love with a girl, much like yourself, and she didn't even know he was alive. And the name of this song is Invisible Man. If you know the words.
Kisses taste sweet like wine, yeah. And how he always makes your heart skip a beat every time he walks by.
you probably spend hours on the phone talking about nothing at all.
Talking about nothing at all.
It doesn't matter what the conversation, just as long as it comes.
feel the need to get with you soon.
Something from Stevie Wonder's Superstition. Before that, I gotta warn Nick and Jeff right there. It's a family show. If I see that hand thing again, I don't know what's gonna happen here. More with 98 Degrees as we return after the break.
Wash your face and hands.
and Justin Gage.
Racing the roof, man. I'm racing the roof.
And intimate and interactive with the guys in 98 Degrees. You can still raise that roof if you like. Yeah, yeah.
Raising the roof. Interactive.
It's a low roof. It's a very, very low roof. So check this out. There's a lot of male pop bands out there right now. Yourself. 90 degrees, obviously. 90 degrees.
That's my favorite one.
That's your favorite one, yeah. Backstreet Boys. And you guys are ferociously breathing down their backs right now. You're all on the charts, but you guys are like moving your way up there. Do you find these other bands act as inspiration for you, or is it an outright competition for you guys?
You know, I think they're great guys, and we're friends with those guys, and they're talented. We just think we're different, and we try to concentrate on our own vibe, our own music. We feel that we're a little bit different, not to say we're better or anything like that. We just know we're extremely different in our musical taste and our musical style. So, you know, good luck to them. God bless them. We pretty much try to concentrate.
Oh, flashbacks. Hey, we have flashbacks.
It's breaking me up. We pretty much just try to concentrate on our own vibe, you know? That's about it.
Right on.
And I think the group that really inspired us most, though, was Boyz II Men. So when people say boy group, and Boyz II Men was the group for us.
Okay. I said male pop. I didn't add the word boy. I'm sorry. I don't want to get any... Nick has some big muscles.
We're older than you are.
So the Wandering Speakers Corner has traveled over to Vancouver. I believe someone has a question for you in Vancouver. So cool. If you guys want to pay attention to the monitor, roll it, Vancouver.
Hi, my name is Nathan Goldstein, and I'm from Vancouver, British Columbia.
I'm Randy Lee, and I'm from Vancouver, British Columbia as well. We have a question. Do you guys mind taking your shirts off? Because me and my friend here, we have a bet going as to who has the best abs.
Okay, did you understand the question?
I understood the question, but...
You said it was a family show, right? So I don't know if that would be appropriate.
For those of you who don't know, it was just Thanksgiving in the U.S. last week, and we all ate like pigs, you know?
Did you?
Yeah, it was
on,
a bad...
Come on, man, let's do it.
Jeff,
man.
you guys want to do something like that? They're saying take it off out there. Well, first explain what you had for Thanksgiving dinner, and then we'll judge from there.
Thanksgiving's a lot of turkey and mashed potatoes and biscuits and pretty much anything you feel like eating.
How heavy was the turkey?
Like 36 pounds.
That's a 36-pound turkey in Nick's tummy. You want to see that?
Oh my God! That's terrible.
It's a few mashed potatoes in there too. I'm one
potato patch right there, boy.
No, it really doesn't look that bad for all of you in Vancouver who are like...
He was pushing out. He was pushing out there.
One lucky person in this room here is going to get the chance to come up here and ask you guys some questions. It's probably the biggest 98 Degree fan in the room right now. And that person... Is everyone ready for this? You're all shaking. And that person is Brenda Codwell. So, Brenda...
I wonder who Brenda is. Who's Brenda?
Wow. So, Brenda, you have a seat right there. What I'm gonna do, Brenda? What I'm gonna do with the guys? I'm gonna take a Polaroid of you guys, all right? So just everyone smile, even you guys back there.
Come on, get in, squeeze in.
You gotta turn the shutter on, genius.
You guys ready? One, two.
You gotta open up the shutter,
Rick. You gotta turn it on, man.
You have to turn it on first.
There you go.
There you go.
Technology.
This guy.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Professional here.
Okay, here we go. One, two. Everyone count. There. I think we got everyone in there. Okay, so now...
Oh, that's a pretty cool...
I'll show it to you in a little while. Brenda gets to ask you guys anything she wants. Is that okay with you guys?
Shoot.
Okay, Brenda, do you want to use the next mic? There you go.
I'm your biggest fan. I love you guys so much, your music. You guys are so talented and amazing. Oh, okay.
Thank you.
Okay, my first question is, what is the biggest obstacle that you guys have had to overcome to get to where you are today?
I think probably first and foremost... people doubting us, people doubting whether we were going to do it, whether we were going to be able to make it. But for us, professionally, we were on Motown Records originally, as probably everybody knows. And our label went through a lot of changes. After Invisible Man, we didn't have a second single really pushed out there. So I think overcoming the turmoil at our label, and now, look at us, we're sitting on top of the world. So that just goes to show you guys, stick with everything, stick to your dreams, and it can happen. So.
And I just want to add to that, too. Yeah. I think in anything you do in life, your first obstacle is overcoming your doubt in yourself and really believing that you can do it. And once you believe you can accomplish what you're looking to do, you can do anything. And that's really, you know, when we moved out to L.A. and did this, we really, in our hearts, believed that it was going to happen. And that was the first step.
Perseverance for you guys. Don't give up until you get there.
Exactly. Absolutely.
Brenda, you like those answers?
Yes. Yeah, those are good.
Did you hear what they just said? No, go on. She's so excited. She's so excited. He's in right there. Look, you're touching Nick's leg. Wow. Oh my God.
That's
more comfortable.
Anything else to add? Okay.
My second question is, what's the best moment that's ever happened, like, in your career or in your life that you remember?
Our best career, best moment of our lives? We've had a lot of professional great memories. One of them was working with Stevie Wonder. We just worked with Mariah Carey. I'm going triple platinum in the States, top 10 singles.
Getting signed,
you know,
the first.
Yeah, I mean,
this feels like a pretty good moment. Having our own special Unplugged with the Interactive and our fans with Canada, the very first fans that embrace us, it feels like a very good moment. This is one of the top ones, no doubt about it.
The top moment for me was...
Right on.
The top moment for me was the day I met Jeff Timmons.
Thank you.
Years and years ago. My life changed and it's never been the same. I'm not sure if that's good or bad, but no, I'm just kidding.
Excellent. Is that, are you had one? Okay, quick.
And if you had any wish for anything, what would it be?
Wow. Mm-hmm. I mean, my personal wish is that we really enjoy what we do. We're blessed because we're able to do what we love for a living, and we get to come to work each and every day, and we enjoy what we do. And I just wish that everyone could go to work and truly enjoy what they do and have a real love and passion for what they do every day.
Right on. Brenda, here's your picture. Okay. I didn't cut anyone off. I almost did, but I didn't. I'm not a photographer.
Oh, right on.
If you guys want to sign up for Brenda right there. Excellent. Sure. Congratulations again.
Very, very good for you. TV, but...
You guys can stay here. I got to cool things down a bit here. It's getting warm. We're going to go to the window again. I got to open up this window. We got to cool things down a little bit, see how the people out here are doing. You guys hanging in there? This is what we're going to do. More stuff with 98 Degrees as an instrument and interactive with the guys continues after the break. So come on back and join us. You're back with an eye and eye with 98 Degrees. That's the picture I took right there. What do you guys think of that? Not bad. I could be a photographer, maybe. I didn't leave anyone out. I did not leave anyone out. Now, you guys ready for some more music here? I say we get to that music before it gets a little too intimate for me. You know what I'm saying here, girls? Let's do it. 98 Degrees, you guys, take it away down there.
Now, this next song is about love. Because love can be such a wonderful thing. But when it goes wrong, it can be the hardest thing.
It's the hardest thing I'll ever have to do.
much as I love to. I just.
Was one of the highlights of our career. We got to work with one of the most legendary artists ever known to man. We got to work with Stevie Wonder on this next song. So everybody, we just want to encourage you to follow your dreams and always be true to your heart.
Come on, everybody, stand up, get up. Bye. Yes, 98 Degrees, true to your heart. Fantastic stuff right there.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
We want to thank you guys for coming down tonight. We want to thank you for watching, and we can't forget about the people outside, Nicole. Thanks a lot for coming down.
Guys,
one last tune, I'm going to play it for you. You can catch it on This Christmas. It's a Christmas CD from 98 Degrees. You might have seen the video on Much Music. It's called This Gift, 98 Degrees, everybody.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It's like, this next song is very, very special.
Hopefully this will get you in the Christmas spirit. Thanks again, everyone, for coming out.
Appreciate it.
Falling, the city is white. Your eyes are shining like diamonds tonight. And we're all alone. There's no one home. You're finally in my arms again. The night is silent and Christmas is here. I couldn't ask for more than having it. It's killing me, it's killing me.
and you, both of us kind of destroyed.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. See everybody.
You guys have a Merry Christmas, all right?